Morning students, I am Girish Prabhakar. Welcome to our YouTube channel where we are providing online classes by DPS Banu Chhapra. So here I am going to start the chapter motion. It is a part of physics of class 9 and first topic is motion. What is called motion? When an object changes its position, continuously with respect to some stationary object and with respect to time, then we can say object is in motion. See, rest and motion is a relative thing. Actually, in this world, everything is relative. Nothing is absolute. Always we are saying something about other person, comparing by other person. Suppose, for example, same person can be your friend and same person can be the enemy of other person. So everything is relative in this world. Nothing is absolute. Same thing, same time, motion is also relative things. We can't say, this object is in motion or this object is in rest. What we have to do, we have to say about the object with respect to some stationary object. You have to take some stationary object and related to that we have to say that other object is in motion or not. So when an object changes its position continuously with respect to some stationary object and with respect to time, then we can say object is in motion. For example, suppose if you are standing beside the road and one bus is moving on the road. So according to you, bus is in motion because position of bus is changing, and same time whatever people are sitting inside the bus, their position is also changing with the bus, so they are also in motion according to you. But the person, those who are sitting inside the bus, what they will say? You are moving backward, or the plants, the trees, whatever beside the roads, they are moving backward. They will think like that, they will see like that. So it is a relative thing. Okay, after motion, the second term will come, distance and displacement. What is called distance and what is called displacement? See, suppose if you are traveling from one point to other point, suppose this first point take as A and other point as B, and the path is like this way. Okay, so you have to go from A to B. You will follow this path and will move along this path and go to B. So actual path, length of the actual path, whatever you travel to reach from position A to position B is called distance. The actual path from A to B, through which, via which you move and reach to point B, is called the distance. But what is displacement? The shortest path between these two points is called displacement. See, distance is a scalar quantity and displacement is a vector quantity. So you need to know what is called a scalar and what is called vector. See, a scalar are those quantity which have only magnitude, they don't have direction. But the vector are those quantity which have both magnitude and direction. For example, suppose I am giving one example that your friend Mohan is running with some speed, say 10 km per hour. Okay, your friend Mohan is running with some speed like 10 km per hour. Is what I am saying. I am just saying his magnitude of his speed. I am not telling in which direction he is moving. Just he is moving with the speed of 10 km per hour. But I am not identifying that in which direction he is moving. So it is a scalar quantity. If direction will come, then it will become vector quantity. Suppose now I am saying Mohan is running with 10 km per hour speed in the direction north, in the direction south. Means here I am identifying the direction, in which particular direction he is moving. So when the both magnitude and direction will come, it will become vector quantity. See here, in distance and displacement, from position A to position B, to reach from position A to position B, you follow this path. You follow this path. Here, always your direction is getting changed. Always your direction is getting changed. It don't have any unique direction. Okay, but the length of this path, the length of this path will give you the distance traveled. Okay, so this distance is a scalar quantity. But see, when you are reaching from position A to B by the shortest path, by the shortest path, it has a particular direction from A to B, and it also have the length, that is called its magnitude. Okay, so it have both magnitude and direction. So displacement is a vector quantity. Whatever topics we studied, we are going to solve one problem based on that topic. Here, the question is given: an object is moving in a circle of radius r. Calculate the distance and displacement. When first one, it completes half the circle, and when it completes one full circle. Okay. Object is moving on which path? It is moving on circular path. It is moving on circular path which radius is r. Okay. So in first question, we have to calculate the distance and displacement when it complete half the circle. Half the circle means it will start from here, it will come here. Means it suppose object is moving on circular path, it means it is moving on the circumference of the circle. It is moving on the circumference of the circle, and we know that circumference of the circle is 2 pi r. Okay, but in first question it is asking half the circle. Half the circle means half the circumference, 2 pi r by 2. 2 get cancelled, and half the circle will become pi r. So suppose an object is moving half the circle, means it will cover how much distance? Pi r. From here to here, it will cover the distance pi r. So distance is equal to pi r in first case, in question 1. Second part is, we have to find displacement also. So in definition, we learn that displacement is the shortest path between two points. Shortest path between two points. So this point is A and this point is B. What is the shortest path? Shortest path is the diameter of the circle. Diameter of the circle. So what will be the displacement? Displacement will be the shortest path between two points. It is diameter of the circle. So diameter is equal to 2r. So second part of this question, what will be the answer? The displacement will be 2r. Now in question number B, we have to calculate distance and displacement when it completes one full circle. Full circle. It means when the object will start from point A and again reach the point A. Then only it will complete one complete circle. Okay. So what will be the distance? Distance will be the circumference of the circle, because it is completing the one complete round. One complete round. So what will be the circumference of the circle? 2 pi r, and it will be the distance of covered by the object in second question. Okay, next one is it is also asking what will be the displacement. So see here, object is starting from point A and again reaching point A. Here a starting point and ending point is the same. When a starting point and ending point become same, then what will be the displacement? Displacement will be zero. Displacement will be zero. Okay. Thank you, students. We will continue the next topics in the next video. Thank you.